everyone, welcome back to Dragania Lost. So we are here for the Dragonyul Iliagasha, which you guys knew was coming today, and it is quite an interesting day indeed, because I will say this, we will do the Shulyubul later on into the video, but I can already tell you that this Dragonyul Ilia will be quite controversial, is the best way to put it, because it's not like that she is bad, but she is a close range mana caster, which is one of my favorite weapon types, that has a very specific niche that needs some limited units to work. So she's not bad, because she's still usable, but you will need a ton of investment to truly make her work, and we will see later on why. Today we are here because I really like Ilia, and I want to see if I can get her with the Wyrmice that I have to spare. This can be a very good gacha if you are lucky, or a very bad one if you are going to chase aimlessly after a Dragonyul Ilia like this one, who has only a normal rate up, so no Gala Dragheia, Prize Showcase with nothing else on rate up, so it might be quite a challenge. So now the true question will be, I have 18,000 Wyrmites, how much am I going to waste on this? Well, half of it, so 9,000. That should be enough in my opinion to get a new character. If we reach 9,000 without getting Dragonyul Ilia, I will think about it, but for now, that's my current, let's say, limit to where I feel comfortable going. The problem here is of course that we have other limited incoming, which include of course the Zodiacs and the possible collab at the end of January, so I don't really want to go overboard, that's my main worry. But I will say this, with probably the middle month rate up being only reruns or stuff like that, maybe there is a more easier time to save, we will see. Probably I won't roll for anything that comes at the middle of the month, that's what I tried to say. Because I really can't, like, limiteds are always a priority for me, because they only come one time over the year, and so it is always better to go for those if you can allow it. Now, let's go into the gacha and check out if we can get this particular Ilia. This is a prize showcase, so to every pull that you have a prize attached. The prize can be something very good like an Adamant Ingot or something very worthless like, for example, a material from the Void Battles. We'll start with the single pulls and then go to the 10 pulls. This week has been very Dragalia heavy. We had the stories of the two new adventurers, the Galagad of Showcase. I already recorded the event story, so you guys won't have to worry about that. Today we have Dragonyul Ilia Gacha, which is the one that you are watching, and then we'll do her story. Tomorrow probably a Dragonyul Ilia Showcase if I get her, if not the event story, and the following day the event story if I didn't get Dragonyul Ilia. It will be the opposite, you guys get it. I'm not really trying to explain something that is obvious. But schedule might change, of course, if there is some stuff that I want to do first, etc. You know the drill by now. Because I am really into doing the FGO main story right now, so I kinda have been giving that a priority over everything that I've been doing so far. Ok, we got a dragon, not the mana caster that we want. Since we are rolling for mana caster, this will be very direct if we get her or not, because if it is mana caster, it is 90% her. Actually, happy to have gotten a Raphael since I can unbind her now, a little bit, ma only have two copies at primo fair, so should be at least a one bind, which is not too bad, but I'm not going to waste Dragon Stones on her, that's what I'm trying to say. Actually, Dragon Stones will be a good price to get from the prize gacha. That's something that I can really use because I have plenty of dragons that I want to unbind, especially limited ones. Ok, at least the pulls are being generous in giving us 5 stars. Of course, what we want is Dragonyul Ilia and her mana caster, so seeing dragons doesn't really help us a whole lot. And remember, when you see the Fafnirs, it is usually a dragon. When you see the middle gem, that is Rainbow, and we got Gabriel. What is this, the Apostle meetup with the Angels, that I'm getting all of them. Next I'm going to pull Uriel, if you guys think about it, that will be quite funny. And so, the best bet over here is that if we get a prize, a high one, I want it to be a Dragonstone, because I can use those for sure. Now, another dragon, wow, this is, like, if it is Uriel, I am going to laugh, I will say as much. Ok, 2 5 stars, one dragon, ok, come on, Managaster, yes, That's what we wanted. My voice went very weird there. We got Simurgh. Not too bad. Breaks the pattern of having Apostle Angel, or rather an Angel. But yeah, Apostle Angel makes more sense because they're contracted. We have, for example, who is it? Lucifer, not Lucifer. What's his name? I don't remember. The Dark Dragon that is also an Angel. Azazel, there we go. Ok, I remember it. Ok, so we are getting to the Mana Caster. And hopefully this will be the one that we want, because otherwise we will get very pissed. Let's check it out in... it is not the next one, ok. No, in 3, 2, 1, come on Dragon Unilia. Yes! Yes, 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 yes! This is the best set of Dragonyul characters that I've pulled in a very long while, because I got both of them without wasting any kind of Wyrmite. And man, I love Ilia and I am glad that I pulled for her. Tomorrow, my friends, showcase for her, day after the event. Today we get the story. Very happy to have gotten this Ilia. I love the design, I love the skateboard, the snowboard rather, not the skateboard. And I do think that I can make a full use of her, because I do have the limiteds that make her work. Galalonidas, Galalaxy, and even Halloween meme, it is a little bit of an idea of mine that can make her work. So happy to have pulled for her. We actually went incredibly well. We only did, I believe, 39 pulls, so we did 3 pulls and 9 tickets. Not bad, not bad at all. We can save up for whatever comes right now. Man, do I have bad memories of last year when we didn't manage to get Dragonyul Lily and we went all in and we were out of commission until New Year's, and even in New Year's we didn't get the same A and we had to high roll for Yoshitsune and we did it. And then Persona came and I didn't manage to get Mona. That was literally the fault of Dragonyul, I still remember it. But today, in 2021, Ilia saved us. Being faithful has its rewards. But well, my friends, with the Gacha conquered, there is only one thing left to do, which is the Shoryu pull. And I will say that this won't be as long as the usual one, which is why I incorporated it together with the Gacha, and actually it works well quite fine, because the video will be nonetheless short compared to the usual Gachas. And I want to say this. I told you earlier, this Ilia needs some needed units to work at their best. She's not bad, that's not what I'm trying to say. She has just a kit that I would call underwhelming for what you could expect from a limited in the third year of Dragalia Lost. So, Dragonyul Ilia is a mana caster, close range. Close range are my favorites, I will be honest here. Many think they are bad, many think they aren't worthwhile, many think that there could be better types of weapons. Personally, I like them. They all have a very specific niche or being multi-hit count type of characters, which work very well with characters that give you shapeshift on every 50 hit combo. So Galalonidas, Galanotte, etc. Those are very good to pair together with a close range mana caster. This holds very true for Ilia, and we will see why in just a second. She has one skill, the second one is just what I would call a pointless skill or a buff. This skill is called Full Throttle Ride. Consumes the entire Alchemy Gauche, this is the usual mechanic that we've seen in the older Ilia. Basically you have a Gauche that goes up to 3, and every attack that you do slowly charges it up. You guys might wonder if it works in Ailidi or not. I've already checked that it does, so do not worry. She's completely Ailidi free, unlike her original alt. And deals damage to enemies directly ahead. If 2 or more cartridges are consumed, this damage and its area of effect will be increased based on the number of cartridges consumed. Changing direction is possible during the attack. So this attack, she goes onto the snowboard and then she launches herself and deals a big away from what I've seen with 2 or more cartridges with decent amount of damage. So you have a baseline damage over here of nearly 1k. And then, depending on how many cartridges you get an extra amount of damage. 700, 12,000 and 19,000. So, the general idea is that you want to use it with 3 cartridges, because you get 19,000 plus the damage that you see right here, which is fixed. Which is basically around 28,000, something like that. Which is not bad for a skill, I will say as much. Especially since it has a low energy cooldown. But, of course, you need the cartridges. The second skill is very simple. Completely fills the Alchemy Coach and grants a team defense amp. Very huge skill energy cost, but she is a cross-range mana caster, so she shouldn't take as much to charge it up. The effect is decent, I will say as much, because it is immediately a team effect amp rather than being a generic amp, but I would have loved if she got something else, maybe with a dispel or an affliction. It would have done wonders for her for sure. Co-abilities have nothing special going on for them, but we have some cute, I will say is the best word, passive. The first one is the usual Ilya passive. Dodging will attack, so it's not actually that bad for her, because dodging and attacking is pretty good if you have the co-ability that gives you the Dragon Prep, the one that Galalunidas will give her, because you get more hits and you generate more Dragon Prep, which is always nice. And then the passive grants her the Alchemy Coach. Feels when standard attacks and dodge attacks connect with enemies, each time one charge of the Alchemy Coach is filled, the user will be granted an Alchemy cartridge, which is something that you already knew from Ilya in the past, so nothing new here. And then she has another passive, which is called the Starfall Spirit. Every time she consumes a cartridge, for 15 seconds she gets a buff that raises her strength and critical rate by 15%. So if you consume 3 cartridges, you get a 45% extra strength and a critical rate, which is not too bad. Especially if you think with the fact that you can attack with a close range mana caster, and so extra crit rate with those amount of attacks can be pretty decent, especially if you raise health critical damage through the roof by using, for example, Arctos, Alluring Mim and the Whirlwinds. That would be a fun build, which I'm not going to do, because I will explain why in just a second. So, what you might think after looking at this kit is that it's very simple. It doesn't give her any sort of utility apart from the defense amp. She has no dispel, no affliction, no nothing that will make her unique in any of the bosses for fire. And I will say that you are correct. This Dragon Ilya is sure lagging on a ton of stuff. However, remember this. If you pair up Dragon Ilya with Galalaxy, which gives her more damage with standard attacks, and Galalunidas, which gives her Dragon Prep every 50 hits, and also you pair it up with Galamars, you get a very, very strong Dragon Battery, because you can rush out Mars. Your second skill will be immediately charged up whenever you get out of Dragon Mode, and you can do sort of, let's say, a spam of defense amp where you can keep up the defense amp level 3. Now, this might not be something that is completely crazy and worthwhile, but it is something that will make it work for sure, because the constant dragon damage will raise her overall damage through the roof, and it's not like that she has bad damage to go along with it. The main problem here is that she needs support. She needs a dispel, she needs someone to flash, to scorch land, or to burn the enemy. She needs someone to support her lagging damage aside from this particular niche. It is a hero that is quite technical, let's say. She needs something to make her work. So, if you ask me if you should pull or not, I will say generally no, because you will need those requirements that I gave you. So, Galalunidas, Galalaxy, Galamars preferably. You can also do it with Gala Reborn Agni, but you miss out on the team defense amp, let's say, battery, which is not essential, but it is still pretty good. And then I would also say Halloween Meme makes her also even better. So, your question hopefully has been answered on if you should roll or not. I will reiterate. Generally, no. If you have the limited heroes to make her work, then she is quite decent, just as a pure source of damage. She doesn't really do anything else if you are looking for a Dispeller, an Affliction Granter, anything of those. She's not that. Personally speaking, I don't really care, because I really love Ilya and I will make her work tomorrow in her showcase, so look forward to that. Well, my friends, kinda disappointed, I will be honest with you here, with the fact that they didn't give her something crazy, but I do think that close range mana caster are my favorite, so I will look forward to making her work. But for today, this is it. I will work on upgrading her, giving her the weapon which I already have because I have Galadonidas, so I already have a full kitted weapon ready for her. And I will test her out on Yaldabaoth, probably. We'll see how that goes. For now, this is it with another Dragonyul Gacha and the last one, I assume, for this year. We actually scored. We got every Dragonyul hero and the Gala without going overboard with the Wyrmites. Hopefully you guys have the same luck and hopefully you spend an happy Dragonyul until it is still going on. Don't worry, I will tell you to spend a Merry Christmas whenever we get down the month also. This is just because Dragonyul is going on right now. For today, this has been Hunter Lodge. Thank you very much for watching. Remember to like and sub to support the channel. And remember to tune in later on today for the Dragonyul Iria story. Let me know if you are going to roll for air, why, how, etc. If you like and don't like the kit, I probably expect you guys not to like it, but I will make it work. I will say as much. I am happy to say, however, that I'm glad that she's back and at least this version is usable in Ailidi, so that's a plus at the very least. Thank you, thank you, thank you once again for watching. I will see you next time and have the best of lucks. Bye, my friends.